favourite mum, Mrs. C, in one of the most iconic TV shows of the 70s, Happy Days. And now at 87, Marion Ross is still appearing on our screens. Angela Bishop caught up with Marion at the Hollywood show. Let's take a look.
Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. The weekend comes, my cycle hums. Ready to race to you.
His sister stand right over.
Oh, I'm not his sister, I'm his mother.
These days are on.
Did I ever meet you in Australia?
You didn't, but you have been. I'm so excited.
I have. I've been to Brisbane, and then I went to Wollongong.
You went to Wollongong?
I did. I did.
What do you remember?
And
about?
Then I went to Hamilton Island.
Oh, beautiful.
Johnny and Chachi, would you mind bringing in the rest of the groceries from the car?
Come on. We're on our way, Mrs. C. Now, you see that? We're going out.
Did a lot of people call you Mrs. C when you were there?
Yes.
Does that happen every single day of your life?
Well, it's many, many, many years since Happy Days was such a big international hit. But people of a certain age, they still are very close to Happy Days.
Oh, one other thing, please, sweetheart. Would you give me some Fig Newtons?
Oh, Howard, you've got two good legs.
Not as good as yours, Marion.
A man drinking warm milk shouldn't get frisky.
There was appointment television. Every Tuesday night here in this country, you had to watch Happy Days at 8 o'clock.
So watch it. Tuesday night, 8 o'clock, ABC. 7th Central. Hey!
And talk about the Fonz the next morning, you know?
Now, where were we?
Oh, you were gonna let me hear your imitation of Chevalier.
Hey, are you crazy? I don't speak French. I only think it.
Fonz was a very important influence on young people, and he knew that, and he took that very seriously. And so he would ask the writers, can we mention that they should all have their vaccinations? And can we mention that they should wear their glasses?
So it made all those things cool.
I could read this card real easily, but it'd be a little blurry, you know what I mean? And why read something blurry when it's unnecessary?
When you got the part in Happy Days, you were doing a bit tough, weren't you?
I needed money badly. Mm. I'd been doing a play. I'd run out of money and I had two children to raise. And I didn't get paid very much for Happy Days at the beginning because my part was, oh, Richie, oh, Howard, oh, Richie, you're not eating. Or it was like the mother was very minimal.
You want any more coffee, dear?
Oh, dear. Would you like something to drink?
Do you have any, Benji?
There were a few interesting guest stars on Happy Days back in the day, too. Robin Williams was
yes,
on as
Moore. Yes.
Who are you?
I am Mark from Mark.
Your buzzer. Hi, your buzzer, your buzzer.
To have Robin Williams, can you imagine? People were coming out of their offices and coming down on the set because word was like an old-fashioned movie. Word was out to go down and watch this guy. We all just start. Everybody back on their heels. See if you can keep up with him.
Okay, would you just mind having a seat?
Seat?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah.
And you also did The Evening Star, of course, with Shirley
MacLaine.
What was that like?
That was interesting because we shot in Houston just forever, it seems. And I played this plain part that she didn't think I looked plain enough, so I thought, oh my God, how plain can I look? And I got plainer and plainer. Finally, I said, do you want somebody else for this part?
You can love them, but you can't live their lives.
Neither can they.
I think it's some of the best work I ever did because I was trying to be invisible. I didn't want her to notice me.
This is for Patsy.
She was sort of difficult, to say the least.
I'm looking for the love of my life.
Not that many more shopping days till Christmas.
Nominated for Golden Globe Award. Even that was like embarrassing. I thought, oh, she'll notice that.
You were worried that Shirley MacLaine would be offended because you...
I don't want her to, you know, notice anything.
I take it you two don't catch up still.
Well, I like her very much, but she was a very dominant character, as you all know.
You're stuck with us whether you like it or not.
You still working?
I must say, I'm very close to being retired. Isn't that nice? The pressure's off. And I have lovely grandchildren.
So have a lovely life.
Beautiful time. Gorgeous time.
Great time. And all, fun fact, the original Happy Days, Fonzie almost wasn't in it at all. He was a tiny little bit character. It was meant to be all about Richie Cunningham and had virtually nothing to do with Fonzie. He'd pop up occasionally in a show, and then people just wanted him more and more, and eventually he got second top billing with Ron Howard, the two of them.
Brilliant.